The Pakistani government has given in to Tahirul Qadri's prime demand. His prime demand was to ask for an inquiry into the June 17 incident. Shafiq is joining us on the phone line. Shafiq, we understand the Lahore Session Court had actually ordered the police to file a complaint and begin an investigation. And now one of the Pakistani ministers has confirmed that they indeed have decided to follow up.
Yes, the Pakistan Railway Minister Saad Rafiq just a moment ago has announced that the government has decided to file a case on the complaint of Minhajul Quran of Dr. Tahirul Qadri against 21 persons, including Prime Minister of the country, Nawaz Sharif, Shahbaz Sharif, his brother and Chief Minister of the Punjab, and some federal ministers and police officials. So this is the announcement made by the Pakistan Railway Minister Saad Rafiq, and they, so far, case has not yet been registered. They just made the announcement, but along with this announcement, the government requested Dr. Tahirul Qadri to end his dharna in front of the Parliament House. And on this announcement, so far, there is no reaction from Dr. Tahirul Qadri's side, which is very important whether this is acceptable to him or not, because Dr. Tahirul Qadri is not only demanding registration of the case, but also removal of Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif and also the Chief Minister of Punjab. And also the dissolution of National Assembly and Provincial Assembly. He has a long list of his demands, including reforms in the electoral process. So this is a long list, and so far the government has offered the registration of case against 21 persons, including Prime Minister and Chief Minister of the Punjab.
Right, Shafiq, you did point out that there is a long list, and indeed one of the other big demands has been the resignation of Nawaz Sharif itself. But clearly, in some ways, this is still a big victory for the Qadri camp, and more pressure building up on the Prime Minister.
Yes, pressure is definitely building, because today is the 14th day of the long march and protest dharna of Dr. Tahirul Qadri's Pakistan Awami Tehreek and Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf. Both the workers and supporters of these two parties, they are staging sit-in, and there is a very much pressure on the government, because the supporters of Imran Khan and the leaders, they are still adamant and stick to the old stance. They want that Nawaz Sharif should step down, and there should be a national government for 2 years, at least for 2 years, and during that two years, there should be electoral reform. And they, both the leaders have time and again praised the Indian electoral system, and they have demanded of the Election Commission of Pakistan that biometric system should be introduced to have a foolproof electoral system in the country, because there is a strong allegation from Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf Chief Imran Khan that Nawaz Sharif came into power through rigging. And there was a massive rigging, particularly in Punjab province, which comprises a 60% population of the whole country. So he believed that Nawaz Sharif came into power through rigging. So that is why he is not accepting this National Assembly. And already the Nawaz Sharif members of the National Assembly, they have hand in their resignations to the Speaker of the National Assembly. It has so far, these resignations have so far not been accepted, but they have tendered these resignations. And also the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf member of the Punjab Assembly, they have also tendered their resignation to the Speaker. So it seems that they are going towards a deadlock, and there will be no solution other than accepting the demand of PTI, or there is expectation or speculation of clash between the supporters or the police, because what we got the information that the government has given a lot of time to these dharnas, and they have now decided to remove these dharna camps of Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf and Pakistan Awami Tehreek. So there is possibility of clash, or the government may come under pressure and Prime Minister may announce resignation, but it's still anybody's guess. There are some MLAs who believe that the Prime Minister should resign, and some people say it is unconstitutional. He's the elected Prime Minister of the country. How he can resign? So it's a long debate, and the coming days and coming hours are extremely important in the political history of the country.
But you're saying that there are growing factions within the Pakistani government who do want Nawaz Sharif to resign now?
Not within the government. In fact, opposition parties and even Jamaat-e-Islami, which is also ruling party with the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province, also this statement came from the Mutahida Qaumi Movement Chief Altaf Hussain that we should save democracy, not the public, and that Nawaz Sharif should show some flexibility and he should resign. So the pressure is building on Nawaz Sharif. Only one leader, two leaders, in fact, the Jamiat Ulama Islam Chief Fadlur Rahman, he is supporting Nawaz Sharif, and also the Nationalist Party, Awami National Party of Aswandiyar Wali, he is supporting Nawaz Sharif. But the remaining opposition parties, they are in favor of Nawaz Sharif stepping down at least for some time to investigate the alleged rigging in the last year's general election.
Well, it is a huge development at this point of time for sure, Shafiq, that the government has decided to register a case. We will keep coming back to you for more. But clearly, at this point, Nawaz Sharif looking more and more cornered as far as the internal politics are concerned.